Welcome to the Crossover Archive. This will be an ongoing series on this channel exploring various crossovers in fiction that I can find, besides most introverse ones and ones for promotion of a mobile game, unless they're really good. At the end of each video, I will score the crossover based on my enjoyment, chance of being canon, how much sense it makes, etc. You can suggest any crossovers for me to cover since I might not have seen them all. Today we'll take a look at the anime Isekai Quartet to determine how canon this could be and to review it. With that out of the way, let's travel to the world of Isekai Quartet. Isekai Quartet is about the four universes of Overlord, Konosuba, ReZero, and Tanya getting transported to a school and forced to become students. First off, this crossover has a slight problem, and that is its chibi appearance, which normally wouldn't be a problem if it wasn't for the fact that three out of the four worlds have chibi anime episodes. What's wrong with that, I hear you ask? The problem is that we don't know the relationship between the chibi versions of the anime and the normal versions. Is the anime crossing the chibi versions of those worlds or the normal versions, or is the chibi shorts canon to the normal version? I asked this for Overlord's sake, since they are the ones that got nerfed when it comes to personality, but that's only if the chibi shorts aren't canon. If the anime took just the chibi versions of the worlds, then there wouldn't be no problem. The YouTuber Chibi Review suggests a serious crossover between these verses, which I'll touch on later, but if that does happen, then the art style will have to be the normal version. This brings into question the first and the upcoming second season. Which version did they use? If the series crossover keeps the events of the first and second season while changing the art style back to the normal version, then that wouldn't be implying that the chibi shorts are canon. It would make sense for the characters from Overlord to be nicer when in chibi form since Toon Force, but what's causing that change to happen? Do they notice? Maybe that would be the plot of the series crossover. Characters realize that their art styles are changing because of a great enemy. If that's the case, then maybe it could work. What do you guys think? Now with that slight problem out of the way, it's time to talk about if this could happen and the logic behind the crossover. I'm going under the assumption that the chibi shorts are canon. The logic of this anime is almost perfect. I think all characters act in character and form believable relationships. The power scaling is also not that bad either, since they don't fight much. Tanya having magic power higher than 8th tier makes good enough sense. Her power was given by a god after all. Reinhardt being up there with Ainz in power makes sense due to the stupid amount of blessings he has. I'm actually glad that they did not fight in the anime, since it would take a think tank of high tier power scalers to determine a winner between those two. Aqua being able to harm Ainz makes sense. She is a goddess that has the advantage of elements on her side. There are other great moments in the anime that also make sense, but that would take forever to go over. Let's move on. Now on to time periods. For Konosuba, it does not matter when this happens, but for the sake of consistency, let's say this happens at the end of the anime. For Tanya, it could be after the anime or movie. Most likely movie, but I haven't seen it yet, so tell me how likely it is in the comments. For Overlord, this takes place after the anime too, since I'm pretty sure Ainz mentioned the Sorcerer Kingdom. ReZero is a bit hard, but I think it had to happen right, and I mean literally a second after the end of the anime, since the relationship between Subaru and Emilia is good, and Rim loves Subaru. And I'm pretty sure in ReZero second season, something bad's gonna happen that would prevent the crossover from happening. Well, at least prevent ReZero from participating in the crossover. Based on all of this, I think the time periods are good, and each one of has a chance to come to the crossover. The thing that goes against this being canon is being X. I don't think he would be happy that Tanya has been taken from him. The solution would be to have him be the one that caused this situation, or have the one that did be so powerful that being X can't do anything, and might even push being X to team up with Tanya. Wouldn't that be something? The gods of Konosuba don't seem to be powerful enough to intervene with this crossover, so that doesn't seem to be a problem. Correct me if I'm wrong. I think that's about it. Overall, this is one of the best crossovers I've seen and worth a watch. I give possibility of being canon an 8 out of 10, logic 9 out of 10, and enjoyment 8 out of 10 explosions. With that, I'm gone. See you later.